John the Bog was happy, he was smoking in the dark. Scored a load at Gloucester Road and was hiding in Hyde Park. His beatific attitude from an old icon was low. But like the early martyrs, he was usually stoned. Saw an Afghan coat approach and a forehead bound with rag. It looked just like a sheep, but oh, it was a wolf in drag. Constable McLagan, with his kaftan and his fur, disguised as Hare Krishna, an agent provocateur. With an evil-smelling, smiling face, he paused as if to pass, sniffing around until he found the roaches on the grass. But John the Bog was happy, he didn't get the point. Since supper time, and here's a freak to share my Sunday joint. All you need is love, he said, and a little peace. So try a little piece of this, it must be Lebanese. McLagan touched his truncheon, but it was too soon to pounce. Said better to be certain, let him roll me half an ounce. Meanwhile, back at the Album Memorial, Ernie Plug was out for bother. He was so cruel and mean. His boots were big and dirty, and his face was red and clean. The park spread all about him. Smiled a crooked smile when he saw two figures on the grass, cause he was an agrophile. Ernie looked at John the Bog, who managed a battery, muttering non-violent things like chit, C and E. He sat there chewing kernels from a San Francisco peach. Soon he was so high that he was plainly out of reach. But McLagan read the writing, his face dripped wet with sweat. He never wrote it up like this in the Police Gazette. He felt his fearful eyes dilate and then dial 999. When Ernie kicked him in the head, which really blew his mind. Hey, Ernie said, and beat him till his beads went pop. Flew about like marijuana seeds. He ripped his wig and kaftan off so all the world could see McLagan lying naked, sore and hypocritically. Well, this story has no hero, but it has no heroine. So light another joystick, babe. Hand me down the skins. McLagan's still in Notting Hill, and he's in Battersea.